Simulcast on 107.5 WBLS and 1190 WLIB.
Well, we're moving to the final days of Black Music Month 2018. Although Black Music continues, it's Black Music Month every day as far as I'm concerned. I know y'all feel the same way. Imhotep, Gary Byrd, the Radio Grill, telling our story, lifting every voice from 107.5 WBLS and 1190 AM WLIB, greeting you throughout the tri-state, New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut. As I mentioned from our Guide to Black Events, we are looking through the stained glass window. This is the one woman play by Evie Rhodes, acclaimed Black woman novelist turned playwright and director. We're going to talk about the production, which has a very special level of dynamics occurring with it, and some dynamics that have reached this sister whose track is playing behind me. I'm speaking of the legendary Melba Moore. We'll talk about it tonight as Evie joins us inside of the experience. Evie, good evening and welcome.
Good evening, Gary. How you doing?
I am well. How are you doing? Your run is continuing. You got a few more days. How have things been going? And tell us a bit about the responses you've got to the production so far.
Oh, thank you, Gary. It's so exciting. We have had standing ovations for almost each run. The buzz on it is really good. People really like the story. They really love the acting. They love the whole setup of the story. And everything has been very positive with people, you know, suggesting that it come to other places. Mm. And it's just been a really phenomenal experience, particularly with a play of this type. It's just phenomenal. It really is.
Great. When we say a play of this type, I mentioned it's a one-woman play. But tell our audience what it's about. What are you trying to say in this production?
In this particular production, this is a piece about a lost Black female voice from the 90s during the AIDS epidemic and during the rise of hip-hop.
Yeah.
When a lot of Black females were affected with AIDS and they were dying.
Yes.
But people didn't quite know what the disease was at that time. And so because of that, a lot of their stories and their suffering got overlooked. And it was something that I thought that being relevant right now with everything that's going on here now today as well, that we bring those voices forth so people know what their experience was.
Absolutely. The crazy part about what you're saying, ironically, I read a piece just the other day about a lecturer who actually was talking to some university students who did not know about the HIV/AIDS crisis. They didn't have the information of the facts, if you will, as recent as that is. So the point of what you're making, especially the impact on Black women, it's still true today.
Yes, it is. It absolutely is. And that awareness needs to be said, and we need to be having those conversations in as many different arenas as we can. And I'm very honored to be able to bring a story of this type forward, so that people can see it and hear it and, develop their own thoughts about it for prevention.
And Melba Moore, speaking of Black Music Month, has shown a special interest in that. Explain to our listeners what that is.
She has. That's really been a blessing. Melba, as you know, is a phenomenal voice. And as it turns out, she has decided to support this play with me because she and I have some of the very same interests in terms of the AIDS crisis. And it was one of those things, is not that I knew that she had that interest or she knew that I had that interest. It was just, you know, one of those things that when it's time for something to come together, it comes together.
Mm.
And so when she learned that I was doing this and that she had that type of interest and background as well, we just kind of merged it and just started to collaborate on bringing this forth together with her talent and with my writing ability and directing ability to bring it out to the masses.
Wow. Wow. Now, tell our listeners where they can actually see and experience Looking Through the Stained Glass Window.
Yes, we're running June 29th, June 30th, and July 1st. We are at 151 West 46th Street in Central Times Square, New York, between Broadway and 6th Avenue. It's up on the 8th floor. People can get tickets at roseenterprises.eventbrite.com. They can also go to my website, which I'll spell out, is www.evierhodes.com. It's EVIERHODES.com. Or they can call 973-289-2215.
Excellent. Evie Rhodes joining us tonight and making a big transition from a novelist to playwright director. Congratulations, sister. You picked a great month to do it in terms of Black Music Month, and we congratulate you on the effort and the response so far.
Thank you. And thank you so much for your support, Gary. I appreciate you, and I appreciate the audience, and I hope people will come out and see it. And I'm just so thankful that I'm able to share this with you guys.
God bless you, sis. Stay strong out there, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
And a quick note, brothers and sisters, that Hallelujah Disco, a multimedia event with the Harlem Gospel Choir in Melmore, is happening, along with the illustrious Blacks. They have set this up for today. They are bringing this show, Hallelujah Disco, to Summer Stage in Central Park. So you might have a chance to check that out tonight. Next hour, Imhotep Gary Byrd's Express Yourself begins now on 107.5 WBLS at 1190 WLIB.
This is Express Yourself with Imhotep Gary Byrd. Simulcast on 107.5 WBLS and 1190 WLIB.